Is this the new radio? Good. The observers are in the tower, but this place is crawling with Germans. We'll have to fight our way through, room by room. On your signal.
Observation post on the other side. Good luck.
Take it from here, Lieutenant. That column of German armor is about to move. We need to relay firing coordinates now. New target, Firepoint Bravo. Angle 78 degrees, range 100 meters. Confirm, over.
Confirm.
Yes! Take that! Direct hit! That armored column is a junkyard now! Thank you, Lieutenant. This has been one hell of a day.
December 24, 1942, Christmas Eve. What we began at Stalingrad, we were to finish as part of Operation Little Saturn on a remote airfield near the small village of Tatsinskaya. Our assignment was to approach the airfield from the north via the River Don, cutting off and encircling the stranded German forces Hitler had forbidden to retreat. There at Tatsinskaya, we would surprise the airfield, destroying as many aircraft as we could, cutting off the resupplying of Nazis in the Stalingrad pocket. This was an assignment I was going to enjoy. But as we were about to spring our attack, the Germans got word we were there and launched a frantic evacuation. We may have missed yelling surprise, but there was still plenty of party to be had.
Take control of the enemy airfield near Tatsinskaya to prevent them from resupplying the 6th Army at Stalingrad. This is a critical mission, comrades. Best of luck.
Raven, this is platoon leader. What is your status? Over.
Platoon leader, Raven here. Our trucks are in position. We need 10 minutes to set up the rockets. Over.
Hold positions until... Stuka! Stuka! Incoming! We have been spotted! Raven, we cannot wait! Get your rockets in position now! We will take care of those bombers!
down by an anti-tank crew. We can't get through to the airfield until somebody takes them out.
From the vehicle, dismount.
This building is crawling with Germans. We need to clear it out.
Thank you. The fascists have barricaded themselves inside the control tower.
Gather some intelligence for headquarters.
Look, this will certainly make some heads turn. Let's get back to headquarters.
Nice bonfire you lit up today, comrades. That should keep us warm most of the winter.
By controlling North Africa, the Axis powers would have a better chance of holding the Mediterranean, now the epicenter of the war. Unfortunately for Italian dictator Benito Mussolini, his army is ill-prepared to withstand the British forces in the region. Hitler, fearful that more losses in Africa would jeopardize his efforts on the Russian front, sends General Rommel and his Africa Corps to clean up the mess. By 1942, the Allies decide that the best way to break the Axis powers back is to create another front. An Operation Torch is born of British and American troops. A well-supported, coordinated push through enemy lines, depleting and destroying fuel, food, and equipment, would mean the eventual fall of the Third Reich in Africa, weakening Axis aggression throughout the world. All goes as planned, and by January 1943, British General Montgomery's 8th Army has Rommel and his troops on the run, scrambling to make their valiant last stand at the Marath Line.
My wife finally wrote saying, Edward Carlyle, just asked to do something else. So I did. It turns out having a background in teaching chemistry can get you out of a desk job pretty quick if you have a mind to it. I knew nothing of Popsky's private army or its ties to the Desert Rats until I was in training. This sabotage platoon's philosophy is lightning-fast strikes and massive explosions deep behind enemy lines. It's gratifying to know that every time we light up a fuel depot or munitions dump, we're stalling Rommel's tanks and helping those poor blighters on the front lines. It may not be fighting fair, but the Germans have hardly fought fair in Europe, so to hell with them. My assignments are highly confidential, so as far as the wife knows, I'm still sitting at a desk. But for some strange reason, I've stopped complaining.
Listen up, chaps. The Jerrys have a cozy little setup in this village here. Our job is to break as much equipment as possible and then dash out before they even know what hit them. Troop B will drive the jeeps behind the Germans and pepper them with machine gun fire. I lead Troop A through town to knock out their communications and burn up their petrol reserves. Carlyle, you're the man with the demolitions. We'll cover you while you set the tank at, say, 4 charges. We'll have to get in and out before everything becomes all spotlights, sirens, and rifles firing. Cock your guns, wet your sights, and ride on. Let's go!